Separation anxiety is characterized by a severe fear of being cut off from a guardian or loved one. It is most prevalent in children, however, adults may also be impacted. When a child is unexpectedly parted from home or a strong attachment figure, SAD can be present. So, what are some of the major causes of separation anxiety?
Separation anxiety is actually a normal stage of development that occurs in very young children and is usually outgrown by the age of 3. However, in some children, this anxiety can actually be a sign of separation anxiety disorder. This intense and prolonged separation anxiety can interfere with school and induce panic attacks. In addition, although less likely, this condition can occur in teenagers and adults, causing issues with leaving home and going to work. Between 4 to 7 months of age, babies develop object permanence, where they recognize things exist even when they are out of sight. In other words, they understand when they cannot see their caregiver, that simply means that they have gone away. However, they don't understand the concept of time and don't know if this person will return. This continues with the child when they are between 8 months to 1 year old and results in separation anxiety, where the child becomes agitated by the absence of their caregiver out of this very fear. In each child, developmental milestones vary, and for this reason, separation anxiety can also be experienced later, for example, between 18 months to 2.5 years of age. However, if this continues to persist throughout older childhood development or manifests in teenagers and adults, it can instead indicate an anxiety disorder rather than a normal developmental stage. Usually, a child must have symptoms of SAD for at least 4 weeks to be diagnosed as having this disorder. For this reason, it is important to consult with a child pediatrician or psychologist where they can do a mental health evaluation. There are several risk factors that might increase the chance of developing separation anxiety disorder, including biological and environmental factors. Some major causes and triggers for this condition include life stresses that result in the separation from a loved one, including but not limited to a parent, caregiver, or pet, a new sibling, environmental issues such as family tensions or moving, and even family history of anxiety. In older children, if separation anxiety appears more suddenly, there can also be a more significant underlying cause such as bullying or abuse.
The first symptoms of SAD may be more apparent when children are ages 8 to 10. This may start after a school break, such as the summer or holidays, or long-term sickness. The most common symptoms of SAD are refusing to sleep alone or go to school, repeated nightmares with a theme of separation, excessive worry when parted from home and/or family, fear of being alone, stomach aches, headaches, or other physical aches or tension, excessive worry about safety of self or family, being very clingy even when at home with caregivers, panic or temper tantrums at times of separation from parents or caregivers. Separation anxiety can also induce other conditions such as panic disorder, phobias, agoraphobia, which is a fear of leaving home, obsessive compulsive disorder, also known as OCD, depression, and other anxiety disorders like general anxiety.
So how can SAD be prevented?
Separation anxiety cannot be prevented and is a normal stage of development. However, when it interferes and affects an older child's daily activities, it is considered a disorder. There are ways to ease the process of separation for children. Practice being apart. Sending children on playdates and letting a trusted caregiver take care of them can help them experience what it's like to be apart from their parents. Creating a goodbye routine and being consistent. This helps the child have a routine and they know what to expect. Children benefit from routines because it helps them feel safe and the fear of unknown is minimized.
How has SAD been affected by the COVID-19 pandemic?
Children's separation anxiety has been significantly impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Separation anxiety has become more widespread as a result of school closings and the fact that many parents are either unemployed, working from home, or in high-risk working conditions. This pandemic-induced SAD has caused a doubling of anxiety in children, with 1 in 5 experiencing significant anxiety compared to 1 in 10 pre-pandemic. During the pandemic, children spent most of their time at home, with several restrictions in place during interactions with others, such as social distancing, masks, or being outdoors. This resulted in several new stressors that may impact childhood development and could possibly delay and increase the duration of separation anxiety. Overall, this is expected to have increased the stress of social interactions that occur with individuals outside their family. When returning to school, children may experience a greater fear of contracting or transmitting illnesses, which may impact their interactions with other children. Since the pandemic is still ongoing, the long-term effects of separation anxiety are unknown.
In terms of treating SAD, there are many ways to do this, including therapies and medications.
Psychotherapy, also known as talk therapy or psychological counseling, involves work with a therapist who reduces the symptoms of SAD. Cognitive behavioral therapy is an effective form of psychotherapy where therapists work to change behavioral patterns through a personal recognition plan. Children will learn how to manage fears around separation and uncertainty. Parents will also learn to effectively support their children using age-appropriate independence. Psychotherapy can sometimes be used with medication. Antidepressants such as selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, SSRIs, may be an option for older children and adults with severe symptoms.
If symptoms of SAD are noticed, the best way to prevent this from impacting a child's development is to contact a health professional.